I'm Tom Hardy, and you're watching the Venom Vlog.
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 The seat, my man.
My man.
Thank you guys so much for being fans of the character that we all love so much.
Thanks for watching.
Enjoy the show.
Hey, what's up, everyone? Welcome back to another episode of the Venom Vlog. And today we have some very exciting news. It was just like a week or so ago, or just over a week ago, we had heard rumors about Andy Serkis and Travis Knight and Rupert Wyatt and, you know, a short list basically of directors that Sony was looking at to direct Venom 2. And we heard even before that with like Atlanta Filming and other people in Atlanta saying that they might start shooting in November. At least that's the plan right now, because Kelly Marcel has already, you know, developed a script for the movie, and we knew she was hired first. Back in, like, I think January or February when they started talking about the second movie, Tom Hardy was, you know, made an announcement, and then Sony and then, you know, the press and everything about how Kelly Marcel's coming back as like the sole writer of this movie, and because she was the one that Tom hired to kind of clean up some of the stuff that he didn't like about the original scripts for the first movie. So now she's like, you know, the foundation. She's going to come in and she's developing the script with, you know, Tom Hardy, because he's like a producer of these movies, and probably with other input from other Sony execs as well. And then they were trying to pin down a director. And last week, you saw my video, I was pretty much rooting for Andy Serkis. And some people were asking me why, because obviously he doesn't have like a long track record of filmmaking. He's got, this will be his third movie. So he's did the movie Breathe, which came out, I think, in like 2015, 16, 17, somewhere around there. And then he did The Legend of the Jungle, which is a Mowgli story. It was like his version of The Jungle Book that he did for Warner Brothers. And other people were like dogging on that. And I was like, hey man, like, you know, he made that movie, and then turned out Disney was making a live-action Jungle Book at the same time. And so Warner Brothers was like, look, we may not be able to compete with this, so why don't we find a home for this on Netflix, at least get the movie out there, at least let people get to see it. And I saw it myself, and I thought it had a slow start, but I actually did end up liking the movie overall. And I ultimately, really what excites me about this is that he's an actor and a filmmaker. And he's an actor who's not only acted in physical form, but he's really good with motion capture. And I just feel like his knowledge on these three things. Okay, he's an actor, so he'll know how to talk to actors and communicate with them and try to get a performance out of them that, you know, might fit the story. Because regardless of what you say of his filmmaking, his acting is top notch. And we haven't really seen him cut his teeth fully on filmmaking, because he's only three movies in. This will be his third one. So I'm willing to give that part, you know, the benefit of the doubt, and think that maybe this is just one of those projects that is kind of a perfect marriage of everything that he's ever worked on, because he's good with actors and he is an actor himself. And he's also good with motion capture. He understands how that works. And I think he'll bring like a fresh look to this universe. You know, with Venom, we already kind of have an established look for Venom. I imagine they're going to change him up a little bit, because in the first movie, they didn't really do mocap at all. They kind of did this other, you know, thing that we talked about, where they just kind of superimpose an image over Tom Hardy there. And so that was like a different technique. And I think it was a little bit cheaper and a little bit, you know, like faster to do. And in this one, you know, obviously they're going to have the budget. You know, the first movie had a $100 million budget. I hope this one doesn't go too crazy. If it goes up to like 125 or maybe 150, I think that's smart, but don't go above that. Don't give this like a $200 million, you know, budget and everything like that, because then you know, shorten the window of profit that this thing could make. Because the first movie cost $100 million to make, and it cost about another $100 million to market, and it made $856 million. So that's a $656 million, well, not exactly. I mean, you got to take like half of that or whatever. So basically the first movie made like $350 to $400 million profit for Sony. And then, you know, anyone who invested in the movie got their money back and then some. So it made a lot of money for the company. And so if you spend $200 or $300 million on something, you know, it has to break a billion. Otherwise, you're not really making a ton of money on it. So I hope they keep the budget a little, you know, still a little tight, but still add more so we can do, you know, better visual effects for someone like Carnage. And that's where I'm hoping he'll bring his style to it, and his knowledge of motion capture is like, okay, maybe we'll keep Venom relatively the same and we'll do some things the same with him, because I liked his size, I liked his physique, I liked his look overall. Looked very comic book accurate, obviously missing the spider, but still looked very awesome. I'm sure they'll make some tweaks to that, but with Carnage, I want to see, like, you know, the skinny, like muscly, you know, tendons wrapped around each other, blood flowing type of look to him. I mean, I really want him to look amazing, and I think hiring someone like Andy Serkis is perfect for at least getting that down, and then also working with Woody Harrelson. I'm assuming he's going to come back and play Cletus Cassidy. I think he signed a multiple contract deal or picture deal, but I don't know for sure. But I'd love to see him come back and you know, and play this character and see Andy kind of work with him, find the heart of Carnage, not the heart like as in like, you know, we want to feel something good about him, but like find who that character is, what makes him tick, what makes him evil, and dwell on that and really make us a villain that we hate. Because I notice that a lot in movies nowadays, they have these villains that kind of in the gray area, you know, like I just saw Fast and the Furious, and as much as I like Jason Statham, he's still the guy who killed Han to me, and I'm like, ah, I liked Han though, Han was awesome, and so you need to rectify that, like, how, you know, you bring Han back, and you know, whatever, so you gotta do something, you gotta figure out something to take away that stigma on it, and that character, if you're gonna try to make him a good guy, and so to me, but we don't get that a lot in movies, where it's just a character that we understand, but we hate still. And I think Andy Serkis, and I'm hoping he can bring that to the character of Carnage. So as you saw in my last video, I was very excited for him. I love, you know, I like Rupert Wyatt. I liked his Planet of the Apes film, and I like Travis Knight, and I liked his Bumblebee film, but I hope those guys go off and do other things and work on other things. And Travis Knight, hopefully do the next, you know, Transformer movie or whatever. Cause I liked what he did with Bumblebee, and I like to see him continue in that realm because he's kind of brought life back into that franchise, and I don't want him to leave just yet. And this one, we knew, you know, Ruben Fleischer was probably going to have, you know, scheduling conflicts, or who knows if there's other things, you know, that reasons why he can't come back. But I'm sad to see him not come back, but he's also going off and doing Zombieland 2, and he's doing a new TV show this fall, I think called Stumptown or something like that. So he's busy, he's working on a lot of stuff, and they needed someone capable's hands to put this franchise in. And I think this is a smart move because it's different. They didn't just make a safe decision here. I think Andy Serkis is neat because it's a little bit of a risk, but it's, I feel like it's one that could pay off. Like I said, he can communicate with actors. He can pull a performance out of them because he knows how Peter Jackson and other great filmmakers that he worked with pulled performances out of him. And, you know, and so he can communicate that well, you know, on set, which will be very key to these characters developing, you know, which is something we all want to see. And he'll even be able to look at something on the page and go, all right, let's act this out and let's see how this goes, and see if we can pull like an emotion out of this scene. And I just feel like he'll add some gravitas to the performances in this film. And that's what I want more than anything. Like the look of the film, you know, you know, if he gets a good cinematographer and he's got a good team, the look of the film will find itself. It'll find a good place, and it'll come across strong, hopefully, as long as he's got a good crew with him. And it sounds like he's crewing up already, because I saw on, you know, he put an Instagram post to make this official, because I'm reading from Hollywood Reporter here. But, you know, Andy Serkis himself did put out this great post on Instagram with like his face, and there's like a red light on him, and he's kind of like looking, giving you the crazy eyes, but also excited, like he's smiling big. And there's a Venom Lethal Protector comic book underneath him, and he says, it's actually happening, I can feel it, the symbiote has found a host in me, and I'm ready for the ride, can't wait. Are you ready, Tom Hardy? Venom, Venom 2, hashtag Marvel. So that's awesome that he's already diving into this. We already know Tom Hardy, you know, had his faith in this, you know, in Andy, because Tom Hardy posted something the other day, and it was quickly taken down, posted something on Instagram about Andy and saying, like, you know, basically saying, like, I hope he gets this part, even though he just used, like, you know, emojis and stuff, but it was, like, clear. He was like, all right, you know, face pullers, let's root for this guy, and I'm glad this worked out, because it sounds like someone that Tom Hardy's excited to work with, and it sounds like Andy Serkis is very excited to work with Tom. And then from this post, you know, Andy tagged a bunch of people in it, and a lot of them were like working on makeup, and they're, you know, like different works in different departments and stuff that, you know, hopefully he's bringing to the movie with him. So I already saw like some people going, hey, yeah, thanks for, you know, bringing me onto this, like Andy's on the job and I just got hired too. And then someone else like, oh, you got hired, I'm working on it too, can't wait to see you. And it's like all these like old friends who've worked in the industry are like coming together. So it seems like already Andy's building a family here with just this one post, and so I loved it. I thought it was great, and it got me excited, and I wrote all those people individually, and I'm like, hey, I do a Venom show, I can't wait to see what you guys do. Welcome to the Parasites. Welcome to the Venomaniacs. And that's how I'm going to treat everybody. Anyone who works on this movie, anyone who's a fan, who jumps on board, even if they weren't a fan of the first one, there's plenty of room for us all together. We are Venom. We are all symbiotes coming together to root for this movie and hope for the best. And so far, it's off on a very good foot. We have Kelly Marcel already writing the script, you know, at least has a good enough version of the script to where Andy Serkis is like, I'm ready to get on board with this. I can work with this. Looks like they're going to try to stick to that November filming and shoot in Atlanta. Atlanta, which is awesome. So I'll keep an eye on @Atlanta Filming on Twitter, and you guys should too. He's not, he always says never use him as a source for anything, but he is there on set all the time when they're, you know, shooting these things, especially when they're outdoors, and he's trying to get a couple pictures and stuff. And I like the guy. It seems like he has some integrity. If someone tells him not to post a picture, he won't do it. And that's really rare in this day and age. And I like that about him. And that's also something I try to copy here. If someone says, hey man, you can't post that, I want to take it down. I don't want to post anything like that. And I try to do a little bit of research, find out if I can post it before I do. So that's why sometimes you won't see me, you know, come right out and just do this. Like this Andy Serkis news, someone was like, hey, did you see the news this morning? I'm like, yeah, I kind of got wind that it's probably going to get announced yesterday. But I had a lot of other stuff to do. I had other videos to put up and I had to go to work. And so I was like, you know what? Maybe this will be a good thing. I don't jump the gun on this on accident. And I just sit back, I go to work, and then I come home and it's already been announced, and then I can make my video. So that's what we're doing here. So yeah, I kind of knew that this was likely going to be announced, but I didn't know for sure. And again, even when someone tells me something, I don't really know who they are. Some people have seen my show and like, hey, well, you know, I'll give you some information. I'm just like, eh, I like being a fan. I like finding out things the way fans find things out. That's kind of the point of this. I'm not here to do like a scoop or get exclusives. I'm just here to, you know, I might make educated guesses sometimes or try to figure something out, like Melora Walters being in the first, you know, Venom movie that we saw and deduced from, you know, the Wikipedia page or the IMDb page. The IMDb page, not the Wikipedia page. But yeah, it's, you know, I try to do that sometimes, but mostly I'm not here to like get a scoop or anything. I'm just here to enjoy the news that's coming out and share it with you guys and give my opinion on it and then hear your opinion on it. So as always, what is your opinion on this? Andy Serkis, you know, this is so cool to me, but I want to hear what you think. Are you excited for this? You know, are you, you know, do you think, oh, well, he's just done two movies, I'm not too excited yet, I got to see a trailer. I know some people are probably thinking that, and that's fine too. But for me, like I said, it just seems like one of those marriage things, like where it's like everything he's ever done that he's good at is all coming together on a project like Venom. It seems very cool for us as Venom fans, but it seems very serendipitous for him. Like I'm pitching a reality show coming up, and in that pitch, it's like a marriage of everything I've ever done. It's like retail, comics, it's like all these things I've been kind of training for my whole life, all in one project. And I was like, wow, how come I didn't come up with this idea sooner? And this is like, all right, you know, really deep characters, you know, like, well, not super deep, you know, but you have a really, you know, interesting character, a psychopath type character with Cletus Cassidy. And then you have Eddie Brock, who there's still a lot more to explore with him because they didn't really, you know, scratch too much of his surface in the first movie. And then there's still more to learn about the symbiotes too. And I think Andy is a good, you know, being an actor, he can pull that out and he can find those stories and he can help tell those stories and translate them to the screen. So that's one good thing. And then obviously the mocap and whatever, you know, technology they use to bring these characters to life in this movie, which will probably be different than the last movie, I think he's great at that and he'll have great input on that and probably knows great people in the business that might, you know, help out and, you know, get involved with this that, you know, couldn't be around for the first movie. But now that Andy's on this one, they're like, hey, I know Andy, I've worked with Andy. I'm willing to bring my studio to the film and do the motion capture for stuff. So I'd love to see that, you know, and obviously he's going to bring that to the table. And then his eye for filmmaking, you know, I do think the two movies he's made were very interesting movies, but I think if he's got even, you know, a better cinematographer, he's got a great cinematographer and other crew members, I think this could really work. And I would love to see Maddie Libatique come back and work with Andy on this one, because I think Maddie has a really great eye for a lot of stuff. And I think with Andy, the you know, the symbiotic relationship that could be there would be awesome. But maybe Andy already has a guy or girl that he uses for his movies. So we'll have to wait and see on that when the full crew starts getting announced. But for now, I'm very excited and I want to hear your thoughts. So let me know in the comments down below. Thanks so much for watching the show. As always, like, share, subscribe, all that fun stuff. And as always, I'll see you in the future. Peace.